Today on the menu, we're going to be making some French dip sliders. For the main portion of this meal, you're going to need the following ingredients. You need some King's Hawaiian Sweet Rolls, 12 slices of provolone cheese, about a pound of roast beef, and to make it extra bougie, some crispy onions. But there's a bunch of other things that we'll need to put in there too. So you're also going to need a stick of butter, some au jus gravy, a half teaspoon of onion powder, a teaspoon of Worcestershire sauce, a teaspoon of minced garlic, and a tablespoon of sesame seeds. Shout out to my brother-in-law, Tom, for making this cutting board for me. Alright, first thing first, we gotta get these Hawaiian rolls out of the package. Alright, now that they're out of the packaging, we're gonna take our knife, and we're going to go through, and we're going to cut all of them so we have a top end and a bottom end. Well, here we go. Alright, so, now we have that, we have a top and a bottom.
Step number next is we're going to start our oven, and we're going to preheat it at 350 degrees. Now that the oven is preheating, we have our pan here, and what we're going to do is we're going to lather up the bottom. You could either use 2 tablespoons of butter, or I like to use my favorite, Pam. Spray that all over the bottom here, and then we're going to take the bottom half of the rolls that we just magically cut, and we're going to put that down. Next up, we're going to put 6 slices of the cheese on the bread, then we're going to put on our roast beef, then our bougie onions, and then more cheese. Now that we have everything put on there, we're going to put the top of the rolls back on top there. Look at that. That looks delicious. Now we're going to make things fancy. We're going to need Paula Deen sweat, or you can just use a stick of butter. That works too. Put it in a microwave bowl and melt it. Now that you got your butter in a bowl, we're going to take the onion powder, the Worcestershire sauce, the minced garlic, and the sesame seeds, and we're going to put it in the bowl. One thing I forgot to point out is that we're going to have to open up the au jus seasoning. We're going to have to take out 1 tablespoon and put that in this mix as well. Once you have that all in there, you want to start whisking it and mix it all up. Ooh, look at that color change.
Alright, back to the sandwiches. What we're going to do is we're going to take that mixture that we just did, I put it in a pourable container, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pour it over the whole thing. Make sure you get all the buns all covered up. Make sure you get all of it. You don't have to use all of it, but since I have no need for any of this afterwards, I'm just pouring it all on here. All right, now's the best part. Now we have our sandwiches ready to go. We have the oven preheated at 350. We're gonna put them in the oven. Let's see if I can do this one-handed. Oh, boy. All right. Notice that I have it uncovered. We want to make sure that it's uncovered here. And we want to have it in here for about 15 to 20 minutes. Now, while they're cooking, we're going to make the au jus sauce. So we're going to take the remaining au jus gravy. We're going to put it in a little saucepan here. And then we're going to get 2 cups of water, and we're going to pour that in there as well. Now that we have all the au jus seasoning out of there, we're going to do just like we did before with other mixtures. We're gonna whisk it. Make sure it gets it all thick. Then we're gonna turn on the heat. We're gonna let it heat to a boil. And then we're gonna reduce the heat and simmer to allow it to slightly thicken. All right, now we're going to get them out of the oven. It's been 15 to 20 minutes. And ooh, this is hot, but it looks delicious. Oh, what's this? My family's here! Alright, now, with the knife that we used to cut the bread, we're going to cut the sandwiches as well. Do not cut yourself. So now that they're cut, I put some of the au jus sauce in a dipping container here, and that's how it is. If you want to give it an extra kick, you can give it some horseradish sauce and put it right on the sandwich. And that's how you make roast beef sliders. Tune in next time when I make, I don't know, literally anything. Thank you.